Hi there. Today on Typical Books, we're going to talk about Diablo. So, this one will be the last book we talk about today. First off, I want to talk about the first Diablo book I ever read. And that's this little nerd right here. Not this little nerd, the book. The book that comes with the game. Now, way back in the day, I had played Diablo and Diablo II on PC. And I'm not on my own PC because I didn't own one like that or that played games. And I was no stranger to things like Doom and Ultima, but I worked in an engineering firm where they had a copy of Diablo that on lunch or very quiet last hour of the days, my boss would play on the local area network. So before you scream LAN party like it's some sort of joke, I tried to not partake at first because it didn't sit well with me to play with my coworkers. But hey, the powers that be were in on it, and if it was a quiet lunchtime, they would often PvP in the office. Now I thought that was super fun, and eventually I did partake, and I really enjoyed that a lot. Like that online sort of gaming, PvP stuff. And it's not something that I typically do anymore, but flash forward many years, and here I am on my lunches playing Diablo III. I've played a lot of Diablo III since it came out. I didn't have a lot of money a couple years ago, and I had bought a used Xbox and then finally upgraded to a 360 and finally got a Xbox One, and all that time it was really to play Diablo. So this little book, because I'm not a collector, because I had limited funds, this little book was my Diablo, not strategy guide. I would go online to like game FAQs and different walkthroughs, Icy Veins, stuff like that, or watch streamers like Bloodshed and Riker and Wolfcryer. Hello. I would definitely rely on that as my Diablo knowledge. And there's some really cool spreadsheets available for super geeks too, right? So I would use that, but I do prefer a hefty tome. This left a lot to be desired. Now I will say that this little tiny book does have some really fantastic art in it. Specifically my favorite, the Demon Hunter. You cannot get past these little tiny teasers of the art that you will find in the larger books. Now this beautiful thing, my husband is a collector himself and he has a real eye for value and a real eye for these sorts of things. So when it came about that he could get a copy of the strategy guide for me, lo and behold, here we are. So this is a beautiful, beautiful book. It has all of the things that you would want to know about demon hunters, any other class. It goes act by act with all of the sights to see, and it is a very wonderful resource as far as what does what in this vast game. I played The Witcher because it is, and people would say that it's just so complex and it's so very big, and there's a lot of really big worlds out there, but being at home in somewhere like Diablo that is quite vast, when it all becomes second nature, it's amazing that all of this information is actually in my brain. It's kind of weird. The denizens of hell. You do get a teaser of some of the little art in here, and there is some suggestions of the larger art here and there, and it's just wonderfully put together. But it is a lot of tables, charts, graphs, small icons. But I will say that it is lovingly crafted. It has a matte black finish, this beautiful marking on the front where you see the fires of hell shining through these claw marks is just beautifully wrought. The back with that shiny black on matte is a wonderful sigil. It's just beautiful. It's a very heavy tome and it's made of some very high quality, high calendared, semi-gloss, high clay content paper that adds to this weight. And I'm sure that if you fold any of these pages, that crease would probably stay there forever and might cut yourself on it because it is just wonderfully, beautifully chosen paper. These blood red inlays, just an absolutely beautiful tome. Now, next on the list is what I had shown in a previous video as far as a haul. It is the collector's edition. Now, this was something that was out of my price range and I didn't need it. I had the game, right? So, meh, didn't need it. And I didn't play on PC. This is the, of course, PC Mac version, which I could install if it wasn't just for the books. That's what it was bought for. And this awesome box. Now, I had shown this off earlier. Just beautiful, beautiful stuff. I will suggest going to other unboxing videos because that's not necessarily what we're going to do here. Because it is old, it's been around for years, guys. Like, you can go and check this out. But I will say, it is just beautifully put together. Now I'd been slipping it off with the other way, but this way you get to see all of the little goodies stacked inside of it, and I really do enjoy the two ways that you can approach this box. I am going to set it down and show off just this little tiny inner box, which I think I want to keep out separately for I don't know what. I do have the beautiful Diablo, and that's really what the prize is in this box, this small Diablo headpiece and the Soul Stone, which contains some DLC and Diablo 2. So if I wanted to play D2, I believe I could get at it in here. There's a lot of really big D2 revivalists, and I'm not one of those, but this is super cool way to get at your D2. And the goal in this box set for me is this original Art of Diablo book, and this is the D3 only book. It only has the original classes, but it is so beautiful and is such a good story tome. I really enjoy the lore of Diablo. And this is, again, a very beautifully put together book. It's a little lighter than the strategy guide. The paper itself is a little lower clay content, a little higher rag or cotton or something. If you're into paper, you'll know what that means. It's a little softer, it's a little lighter. It might be more susceptible to humidity, I believe. Now the art is just, oh my gosh, beautiful concept art in this, beautiful finished renderings and paintings. It's just such a beautiful book, and it's typeset so beautifully. I just absolutely love every single page in this book, and it was a beautiful find and really a good compliment to the other books that are now adorning my shelves. It has this old-fashioned looking inlay, sort of like a hammered tin roof. It has another sigil on the back, and they're continuing with this trend, this shiny on black matte. And the frontispiece is just absolutely beautiful. Okay, so now the big guns, the most recent book that was put out. And this is the book that infamously spoiled D4. A German company was releasing the book and they had some spoiler material on an online site that was showcasing the book. It might have been the publisher. And everyone went ballistic because they said straight up the art of Diablo, Diablo 2, Diablo 3, and Diablo 4. And it was not a typo, it was not a translation error, which many people had thought once people ordered the book, because that's what you do when somebody teases something like that. It was confirmed that, oh yes, this absolutely is the first official leak of D4, like really official. But again, it is a beautiful, not quite as heavy. It doesn't have that same weight to it as the strategy guide for D3 does, but it does contain some straight up beautiful artwork, and I think it surpasses the other books in its quality of art and its attention to just the detail of the character pieces and some of the larger representations of the concept art. We get a lot more background in some of our favorite places. We've got these beautiful shots of Westmarch. Pandemonium, one of my least favorite places to visit, but one of my most favorite places to look at. And just a lot of beautiful detail that goes into some things that we haven't seen in the game and won't see in the game. We've forgone this hammered tin or blood red inset on the in the inlays, but we've got a picture of perhaps a demon ravaging town folk. We have a nice little shot of Malthiel in the background, one of my favorite characters from Act 5, and one of the save scenes that we're heading into Act 1 in D3. This is the loading screen artwork. Diablo IV's artistic vision was built using several key pillars. Return to Darkness, Embrace the Legacy, and what the art team calls the Old Master's Pillar, which was shorthand for striving to make each part of the new game look as if it was painted by a venerated artist such as Rembrandt or Ilya Repin. And in the teasing that we've seen so far, I mean, I think they've hit that mark. It looks very beautiful, very dark and washed out in a way that you can only get from like an old sepia look, and just gonna be absolutely gorgeous to run around in. Some of the concept art near the end of it is reminiscent of almost Silent Hill. And all in all, it does hearken to what we've seen in the teasers so far as that attention to detail, that dark beauty, and of course, the sort of savage hellscape that can only find is something like Diablo. So there you have it, a whole slew of Diablo books, Diablo III books specifically, and The Art of Diablo, which is basically a catch-all, but hey, we got a little teaser of D4 in there, and that is my Diablo books. I do play on Twitch at lunchtime most days for a half hour, so it's super quick, but I'm going to post up a video of a 28 minute playthrough where I'm just sort of running around in a rift. That's what I do. It's nothing really serious, but it's mostly chit-chat and catch-up, and I talk books and podcasts and horror and news and whatever. So I'm going to post one of those up to go along with this. It's sort of a departure, I know, but it's books here on Typical Books. Typical Books and Lydia Plays Diablo are the two videos I'll put up today. And then we'll get back to some horror books. So I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for being a Diablo fan, and have an ooky, spooky day.